Here at the Upendo village, there's just an atmosphere almost like heaven on earth. You walk and hear the kids' excitement for you, and you can see them, and you can just see how excited they are that you came. That feeling, just knowing that someone cared so much every time you see them, it was just like having God, knowing that every time He saw us, that's the way He feels.
In the very beginning, when we were on the bus driving into the orphanage, the first thing that you could see and hear were 62 kids singing and cheering for us. And at that very moment, I knew that this trip would be incredible. They were just filled with so much of God's love, and it was extremely contagious. I couldn't help but smile and laugh every single time that I saw them. That allowed me to reflect in my own life. I realized how many times I don't have joy, even when I should. It just amazes me how God's presence is so prominent all over Africa. I was so overwhelmed by His work, I had no words. But overall, going to Malawi has impacted me in so many ways. I can't imagine not being able to witness the ultimate glory of God through these kids. And He made a change in my heart, and I hope that I'll be able to come back again sometime soon.
Once upon a time in a faraway land, there lived a loving king who created a magical village for the children who needed a home. The home was so wonderful and the children so precious that no one was allowed to visit without a personal invitation from the king. There was one condition: those who are invited must arrive at night, because the king's children loved to dance under the bright twinkling stars. Perhaps you will be invited to this magical village to dance under the stars with the king's children. The invitations arrive in your heart.
One little girl I connected with named Rachel. When we met, it was evening. I was holding her and she fell asleep. I could feel her arms wrapped around my neck and her head buried into my chest. Ever since then, she and I are always together. She has this spunky, energetic personality that is contagious. Every day we dance and sing together, even if we are the only ones. Despite the language barrier, we make jokes and get each other to laugh, but they have an overflow of joy and love that is nothing like I've ever seen. I came here to show God to the kids, but as I leave, I'm realizing they are the ones showing God to me. You could feel their heartbeat, and you could feel how tightly they grasped you, and even if I like let my hands go and put my arms out, they'd still cling there because they were just holding on so tight. or they look up at you with this great big smile, and they just look so happy. And they were willing to stay there until you couldn't hold them anymore. Like, they just loved to be held.
This is Dr. Birch. I'm reporting live from Upendo Children's Village. And Trinity, what do you make of the bubbles? There seems to be a lot of bubbles going on.
They're fun. I don't know. They're bubbles. They like making beards and pretending they're old pastors.
I think I need to investigate this. Ines, what's up with all these bubbles?
What happened to you? Are you okay?
It's chaotic over here. It's like a bubble storm. I'm not even kidding.
Ben, this is Finney, Malawi. What's up with you? You have been attacked.
I started the trend.
You started the trend? Yeah. You look good with a nice gray beard.
Oh, thank you.
Julia, what do you think about Ben?
It looks like something that will go in the future, that you know, just
yeah,
like a glimpse
future,
of the future.
Like 40, 50 years?
Yeah, maybe you're like 10, you know.
What happened?
I do something.
You do something that's right. Oh, my. Are you eating those? Please don't do that. Parable of the bubbles. It's happening. Oh, here comes another one. Becca, what is going on here? These bubbles.
Oh.
Hi, Brianna. Shut up. How are you doing? Nice to see you. Look forward to showing you this film. There is chaos here in Upendo. Have some chaos. All right, bubbles are taking over. Pray for us.
I see God in through creation the most. He shows his love through the art that he paints for us.
So this trip just really expanded my view of the world and God's creation. And it just showed me that the world that I live in is not just me at home in New York, but that God's hand stretches across the nations and his purpose is seen throughout the world. And it just really opened my eyes to how big the world is.
We thank you for these lives that have been saved in your name. We pray that they may be changed for you, Lord. We pray that they may hear your voice. We pray that they may step when you step. That they may only speak when you speak. Lord, we pray that their love overflows and that it can't even be contained, and that when others see them, all they see is you, Lord.
what really defined this trip for me was the instant acceptance I felt from almost everybody here. What I was most excited to do was interact with the kids because I have a passion for the youth, but I've never been loved back as quickly or as well as these kids have loved me. So really, I think I came with the mindset that I was gonna share God with these kids, and I was gonna have to be a light. I was gonna have to be perfect. I was gonna have to do all these things. I was gonna have to model Jesus to these kids. But more and more, just being around them and the joy that they show and the absolute love that they give out every single day, I really felt God minister to me. And I really hope that's something I can take back when I go back to America and back to everyday life. I really hope that I never forget what I've experienced and what I've been given here, because that's really what's happened. I've been given a great gift, a great experience that I hope I never forget.
Perhaps you will be invited to this magical village to dance under the stars with the king's children. The invitations arrive in your heart.